Spring season means lacrosse season. And while the Syracuse men's lax team is going through the final stretch, the women's side is currently making history. The Orange are the number one team in the country for a program best four straight weeks. With offensive stars Megan Tyrell, Megan Carney, and Emma Ward taking the spotlight, and Delaney Schweitzer standing tall between the pipes, SU is an undefeated 14-0. But that record is at stake this weekend when the Cuse takes on number 5 North Carolina, last year's reigning champs. We're talking women's lacrosse on Cuse Countdown, and it starts right now. Well, the time is right now. Welcome into the Citrus TV studio for Cuse Countdown with Jack Gordon and Leo Silverman. I'm Ben Spector, getting you set for number 1 Syracuse women's lacrosse's upcoming matchup with number 5 North Carolina. But in SU's last matchup against number 19 Clemson, the Cuse showed out. Jack, 5 different players poured in multiple goals. Emma Ward had a season high 5 scores, and the Orange had a 4 tally lead after the first quarter. Just an overall complete show.
Ben, look at that. The usual suspects once again. We had 5 goals from Emma Ward, 4 from Meg Tyrell. They had their foot on the gas the whole way through, and they didn't slow down.
And Jack, something you don't see up on that stat sheet is the amazing work behind between the pipes for Delaney Schweitzer. 14 saves in this one as well, just to encapsulate such a huge win for the Orange.
Guys, it was a domination against number 19 Clemson, but let's go back to the beginning of the season. 2022 was a year filled with letdown. ACC quarterfinal loss to Virginia, followed by an Elite Eight defeat at the hands of Northwestern. That wasn't going to cut it for the Cuse, and the Orange began 2023 with an immediate chance at revenge. Let's paint the picture. February 11th, the then 5th-ranked Orange against the then 4th-ranked Wildcats. Location? The Dome. It was a back-and-forth affair. Attacker Megan Carney led the way with 4 goals, and that includes the first score of SU's season. But with just over a minute left, grad student Megan Tyrell sent a dagger through the hearts of NU, and SU began 1-0. From there, Syracuse was off and running. Enter the second and final Big Ten opponent of the regular season, then number 2 Maryland. February 17th is a day that SU fans can think of as the day the Cuse broke out. The Orange were dominant on offense and poured in 11 first half goals. Megan Carney, Megan Tyrell combined for 10 tallies as the final whistle blew, and Syracuse danced to a quick 2-0.
After the 2 ranked wins to start the season, Syracuse got a little bit of a breather. The Orange faced 4 unranked opponents and took care of business, to say the least. The Cuse won by over 10 goals per game. Megan Carney and Megan Tyrell showed out in the Binghamton game 6 points apiece. And how about this Pitt game? The Orange just bullied the Panthers into 1 goal per quarter. Not very nice to a program that's only been around for 2 years. Syracuse followed that up with its most dominant win of the season over UAlbany, then a double-digit victory over Virginia Tech. Those 4 got the Cuse geared up for the next stretch. Let's start with number 12, Notre Dame. Emma Ward was tossing dimes. 7 assists to help the Orange to a 15-7 win. Then Syracuse went down to Loyola, and they had a tight one with the Greyhounds. Down 6-7 in the 4th, Sierra Cockrell ties it up, and SU goes on a 3-0 run to win. Next destination, Durham, North Carolina. Syracuse took down number 15 Duke 16-10, 5 goals from Megan Carney. Then the Orange went from number 2 to number 1. They faced number 6 Stony Brook. Long Island native Emma Ward showed out 3 goals and 2 assists for a 16-11 win to go 10-0.
From there, it was smooth sailing for the top-ranked lax team in the nation. SU's first breakaway from ranked play in over a month brought another one-sided win, 17-5, over Louisville. Cornell proved to be no match either, falling to the Orange 3 days later, 19-13. But what impressed the most about this soft part of the schedule for SU was their dismantling of their last 2 opponents. Virginia came into the JMA Wireless Dome ranked number 11 in the nation, and the Orange just straight up embarrassed them, 21-9. Clemson the following week in Death Valley, also the top, in the top 25 at number 19, completely outclassed in their own building, 19-10, thanks in large part to a career-high 7 points from Olivia Adamson, the conductor of the top offense in the nation. Now, with 2 games left in the regular season, Adamson and Co. will have their offense tested against the best. Number 5, UNC, may be the best defense in the nation, especially on home turf. And number 7, Boston College, are riding a 5-game win streak of their own. But if this season has shown anything about this SU squad, it's that they're always ready for anything.
Leo, this SU squad has been playing like it's ready for anything all season long, 14-0, a big step in the right direction. So 14-0, best record in program history up to this point, number one for the first time since 2014, and has held that top spot for a program best 4 straight weeks. Guys, I can go on and on. So who has been the key contributor? Look no further than Megan Tyrell. Leo, the grad student leads the team in points with 75 and headlines an offensive group that's one of the most dangerous in the country.
And Ben, the important part is that she does it not just with scoring, it's in both facets, right? It's not just scoring, it's both creating for her teammates and scoring. You're sitting there looking at, you know, I believe 41 goals and a high 30s in the assists as well to get this point total. It's absolutely amazing. The greatest attackers in lacrosse don't just know how to score, they know how to create for others, Jeff.
That's exactly right, Leo. She can score at will if she really wanted to. I believe she could put up 5, 6, 7 goals a game, but that wouldn't make her team any better. So instead, she decides to help everybody else out. That's why she's got so many assists this season. That's why she's quarterbacking one of the best offenses in the country.
You look on your screen, Megan Tyrell is 8 points away from tying Katie Rowan, that leads the entire program in most points in a career in an SU uniform, something that Megan Tyrell can certainly accomplish against North Carolina this weekend, guys. She has had games where she's had double-digit points, so it's not totally out of the realm of possibility. But from the offense to the defense, last season, there was a bit of a split in net between Kimber Hauer and Delaney Schweitzer. The two attempted to fill the shoes of the recently graduated legend, Asa Goldstock. But Jack, this season, Schweitzer might have accomplished that feat, and the senior has had 4 ACC Player of the Week awards this season.
She has been so incredible, Ben. You know, it's kind of unheard of for a goalie to have a tough season like she did last year and then double her save percentage. She's over 50% this season, arguably the best goalie in the country right now, and that's why this team has completely changed. You know, this has been a little bit of a rough spot. Talk about last year, that was the weakness of the team. This goalie play this season has turned them into a juggernaut.
Jack, how crazy is it to think that the 315 might have two of the best goalies in the nation in lacrosse right now, including Schweitzer. It's crazy, you know, a lot of people talk about the save percentage number 5 in the nation. Is she really the best? But I don't think any other goalie in the nation has been going consistently against the high level of competition Schweitzer has. I think she's the best in the nation.
Schweitzer has been in positions where she's had to stand on her head. 15 saves against Virginia Tech earlier this year, just one of those examples. And SU, we've said it time and time again, but it's hard to not talk about. 14-0, undefeated number one team in the country. But amidst all the success, Syracuse has had to go through some adversity. Defender Bianca Cheverie is hurt, midfielder Jenny Markey dealing with an injury, and draw control specialist Kate Mashevsky is out for the year after she left the contest against Notre Dame earlier this season. The injuries piled up, but on the flipped, players have stepped up, namely Olivia Adamson, who was jubilant after a career day against Clemson just last week.
Oh my God, that's awesome. Wow.
All the credit to our circle people and our coaches, and having Kate be able to coach me up during the week is awesome. I was just seeing the ball really well, and my teammates were doing a great job boxing, and it was awesome all over the board, but I wouldn't be able to get 14 draw controls without such great circle play. That was awesome.
Leo, Adamson credits the circle play, but what has made Adamson, among others, so good in new roles?
Well, Ben, it's just the people we've touched about, the veterans in this offense already. You know, the Megan Carneys, the Megan Tyrells, they boost up other players on this team. And Olivia Adamson is that benefactory, because when you have to worry about the Megan tandem, you're just simply not focused on a player like Olivia Adamson, and there's just the coaching staff as well, being able to get these players to step up in big spots.
Yeah, it really speaks to the depth of the entire team and the program itself, that they can recruit so well, and they can find players like Maddie Baxter or Mackenzie Olsen to come off the bench and be just as good as almost any starter in the ACC. That speaks to just how good and how strong this program is right now.
Couldn't say it better myself.
Leo, you said Megan tandem, someone we haven't mentioned at all up to this point. Megan Carney leads the team in scoring with 44 goals. over 40 goals up to this point. That's very, very impressive. Emma Ward as well leads the team, 45 assists, a name you guys really haven't touched on thus far. It just goes to show how much depth SU has in 2023. Well, we're going to our first break here on CC, but on the other side, we'll break down the opponent, the scary number 5 North Carolina Tar Heels. Cuse Countdown, we'll be back in 90 seconds.
Jason, let's go see your room.
What do you think? We kept it a little spare, so you can decorate it how you like.
Dinner!
Go?
Excellent.
Soccer's fun.
Yeah, I saw you guys out there.
We're the family. We're the family.
Yeah!
Oh, I thought you were on my team.
Wait.
Welcome back to our Citrus TV studio for Cuse Countdown with Jack Gordon and Leo Silverman. I'm Ben Spector, getting you set for number 1 Syracuse women's lacrosse's upcoming matchup with number 5 North Carolina. But we talked about Syracuse earlier on in the show. Now we focus on the Carolina Blue. And Jack, this program has won, get this, the last 6 ACC titles, the reigning national champions, and has beaten Syracuse 7 times. So you got the 6, then you got the 7. What's contributed to such great success?
Ben, they really are the gold standard right now in college lacrosse on the women's side. They've done such a good job just building a program, whether it's coaching, recruiting, and doing the right things on the field when they need to. They've done such a strong job and having a good foundation. You know, it starts with their defense and their goalie play. They always have all Americans on that side of the ball, and that really fuels just a strong team.
And Jack, year in and year out, this squad has also just shown such good composure in those pressurized moments, and that really speaks to that foundation and that coaching staff to make sure no matter how bad the going gets tough in some of these games, they stay composed and they're able to fight back and win so much hardware.
You talk about the foundation, you talk about the recruiting, offense, defense. Well, and Leo, you alluded to it just a little bit there. You can't talk about the Tar Heels without mentioning their head coach, Jenny Levy. Leo, she is a Hall of Famer, ranks 3rd in D1 lacrosse in career wins, and is a 3-time National Coach of the Year. There's a reason she's been with North Carolina for 28 seasons.
And there's a reason why North Carolina has been on top of the ACC and the nation so many times throughout her tenure. I mean, you know, you've spoken on it already, the composure, but she's able to bring in the recruits as well, keep this team always on top. It's just amazing to see and look at her accolades record stack up, and she's not even done yet, Jack.
You know, Leo, it's funny to see a coach like Jenny Levy going up against Kayla Traynor. Only Traynor's right. Second year in this thing.
Yeah.
Levy's been going at it for a long time, and it's so impressive that through 28 seasons, she hasn't missed a beat. She's keeping up with the changes of the modern game. You know, lacrosse is always changing. It's become more of an offensive sport, and recruiting changes, NIL, all those types of things. Jenny Levy is still on top of the coaching game.
And on your screen, you see Jenny Levy holding a national championship trophy. Well, she's got 3 of those. And guys, whenever you think of North Carolina entering a women's lacrosse season, you think that the Tar Heels are in contention to win a national championship, especially this year, number 5 in the country. And you talked about defense a little bit earlier. Levy has worked with great defenses in her nearly 30-year tenure, and this year it's certainly no different. The Tar Heels have the 5th best scoring defense in the country. So Jack, who have been the biggest contributors on the defensive side of the ball for UNC?
Ben, they have a lot of leadership. You know, a player like Emily Knowles, a senior on the squad that can play tough defense, she can get out and run, and that really changes this team because she's someone that can turn defense into offense, and she's been around for a little while. You know, North Carolina's been to the last Final Fours, which means she's been to all of them because she's been here 4 years. That's four Final Fours for Emily Knowles, and she's been right there with them the whole way. Such a strong defender.
I've been so impressed by Knowles as well, Jack, because she's leading this team in that cause turnovers bracket, which in the new modern game, like we keep talking about, causing turnovers becomes so much more important when we look at these offensive possessions from these high-powered offenses, and Knowles is leading the Tar Heels in that stat.
And as you get late in the season, North Carolina and Syracuse go head-to-head. SU, one of the best offenses in the entire country, get nearly 17 goals per game, so it's going to be a good matchup for Syracuse offensively and North Carolina defensively, two really strong groups going head-to-head. But you might look up and down the roster. You go up and down the list and you say, look, where's Jamie Ortega? Well, guys, she graduated, but that's a big loss. Ortega was the first five-time All-American in UNC history. So, Leo, now that Ortega has graduated, she's gone. Who has stepped up for the Tar Heels offensively? Don't wipe her away. Like, I mean,
it's a lot of eligibility. She played a long time, and
she's very good. But she's not on the team anymore, so who stepped
up? Ben, you're right. I can't be wiping away. The 400 goals, it's going to take all of my force to push away.
Forget about it now.
But, you know, honestly, Jack, Riley Casey has been really impressive. Looking at her, you know, her splits from year to year. Last year, limited time, scored, played in every game, but limited in those games. Scored about 8 goals through those 22 games. We're 13 through now. Already nearly tripled that number, and it really just speaks to how this, you know, we already talked about the coaching from Levy. Such a good job to make sure people like Casey have been able to step up and fill some of the goals missing from Ortega.
And those other goals that Ortega hasn't scored, they've been filled by Caitlin Wurzberger. She's been so strong this season, 51 points this year, and her efficiency is so impressive to me. Shooting 65%, that's who you want leading your offense. You know, you don't want a high-volume shooter that isn't always putting it in the back of the net. Well, Wurzberger's knocking it in 65% of the time. Ooh. And as a junior, too, you love to have it be an upperclassman lead the team, so it's been very impressive to see Caitlin Wurzberger this season.
Let's say that stat again. 65% shooting percentage. You miss 100% of the shots you don't take, folks.
She makes 65%.
She makes 65% of them. That's exactly right. This year's matchup should be a good one. Now, though, we travel back in time. Get your time machines. Not too far, though. April 9th, 2022, win the Dome, then top-ranked UNC, and then fourth-ranked SU. Went head-to-head in a back-and-forth affair. The Tar Heels were up 3 with 8 minutes to go before Megan Tyrell and a young Natalie Smith brought the deficit to 1. But, Jack, UNC pulled away with a big-time win in early April.
Listen, Ben, this is the one team. You're listening?
I'm listening.
This is the one team Megan Tyrell has not beaten in the ACC. She is kicking herself about that. She's performed in every single one of those matchups, played so well. But to lose a game like this where it goes down to the wire and you're right there with it, couldn't get over the hump, and that's so tough for a player like her that's done almost everything other than win a national championship, yet she wants to beat North Carolina so bad.
And Jack, this game was the definition of razor-thin margins. I mean, we look up and down the stat sheet, shots on goal, draw control, assists, I mean, even the goals, everything, it's a razor-thin margin. But you know what the difference was? It was the Levy effect, because right when this game got close, what team pulled out? The Tar Heels, they stayed composed, and they were able to get the win.
And Kayla Traynor now has a year under her belt. Second season, Syracuse and North Carolina going head-to-head this weekend. This was a matchup last season that SU had circled on its calendar. I guarantee that this weekend's matchup is the exact same. We're going to another break here on Cuse Countdown. On the other side, Jack and Leah will either become facilitators or scorers. You won't want to miss it. Stay with us. It's Cuse Countdown.
Here's to the straggly ones. The first ones. But hey, I look good with this ones. The black, brown, red, and gray ones. The itchy ones. The ones grown by dad. All right. The ones grown for dad. The I nearly didn't do it this year ones. And the absolutely filthy ones. They all raise awareness, raise funds, start conversations, and save lives. Because whatever you grow will save a bro. Learn more at Movember.
Welcome back to Cuse Countdown alongside Jack Gordon and Leo Silverman. I'm Ben Spector. Guys, Syracuse's offense is stout. Second most goals in the ACC. So I'm not sure if you guys can keep up with that offense, but we're going to see in this game of pass or shoot. Simple, I give you the prompt. If you disagree, you pass. If you agree, though, you better rip it towards Cage. I mean, you better put a lot of velocity on that shot. So we'll go to the first prompt right here. Syracuse will have its first Towaratom winner in program history this season. Jack, you passing, you shooting?
Ben, let's go with a player with a lot of velocity on her
there
shot.
You go.
That's Megan Tyrell. I'm shooting this one. She's definitely going to get it. I think she's the best player in the country with 80 points this season. That's second most in the NCAA, only behind Izzy Skein. We might call her a stat patter, though. I think Meg Tyrell's points are worth every single one of them. She's guided them to an undefeated season.
Jack, I'm ripping it with you, too. Going bar down ski on this one. It's Megan Tyrell. This is going to be the first Towaratom winner for SU. You stated in every single capacity we talked about earlier. But nobody in the nation is facilitating like she is and scoring in droves like she is as well.
Megan Tyrell, 8 points away from tying the program lead for most points in a career in an SU uniform. You guys forgot about Izzy Skein from Northwestern. I just want to put that out there. Out there as a potential candidate. But anyways, we'll move on to the next prompt here. Will Syracuse finish the regular season undefeated? Two more games to go. Number 5, UNC. Number 7, Boston College. Syracuse currently 14-0. Leo, does Syracuse finish undefeated?
Ben, you know I'm a sucker for storylines. And this storyline, I'm shooting towards Cage. It's a yes. Listen, this game has too much revenge around it for SU. They have this game double circled on their calendar. I think they'll be able to pull this one out. And you're telling me SU's going to close out their season in the SU soccer stadium where the defending national champions,
turf,
they're going to lose there to the undefeated season? You're kidding me. They're finishing this regular season undefeated.
Leo, I'd probably be having a lot more fun if I had the same answer as you, but I have to pass.
Ooh.
I'm just playing the odds here. You know, whether it's North Carolina or the game after Boston College. Those are two great teams, top 10 teams in the country. I think there's a shot that they lose one of them. I'm going to say no. I'm passing.
Syracuse has had trouble with North Carolina and Boston College in its recent past, so two very tough opponents to close out the regular season. We'll see if Syracuse gets the job done and finishes 16-0. But now to postseason play. Will Syracuse win the ACC tournament, a tournament it has struggled with for the past 6 years? North Carolina's won the last 6 titles, and Syracuse fell to Virginia in the quarterfinals a year ago in South Bend. Jack, you passing or shooting?
I'm shooting this one all the way to the championship, Ben. I think they get it done. They might lose one in the regular season, but they get the revenge in the ACC tournament.
Jack, I am unfortunately reversing here.
I'm feeling
the pressure. I'm passing this one out. I don't think they'll be able to take the ACC tournament purely for the fact that I subscribe to logic, defense wins championships in these tournament formats. I feel like SU might just find a game where that offense doesn't get going and they're going to get caught.
That offense might not get going against maybe, I don't know, UNC with the 5th best scoring defense in the country. Potentially a preview of that matchup this weekend. One more break here on Cuse Countdown. Jack and Leo, guys, have a metaphor they want to tell you regarding this Syracuse squad. You won't want to miss it. Stay with us. Closing up shop here on Cuse Countdown with Jack Gordon and Leo Silverman. I'm Ben Spector. Thank you so much for joining us as we preview Syracuse's upcoming matchup with North Carolina. Guys, when you think of great groups, you might think of the Beatles, the 2016 original cast of Hamilton, and maybe even the Avengers. Well, this SU squad, to me at least, and I know you guys feel the same way, is eerily similar to that of the Avengers. And if that's the case, Jack, who's who? Let's run through it.
Well, we got to start with Megan Tyrell, okay, right? She has to be Iron Man. We'll call her Iron Woman for now. She's been there throughout it all, 5 years now. She doesn't miss a beat. She hasn't really gotten injured or anything like that. She's always there to play. That's why she's so special.
And then you got Megan Carney, that Captain America, the goal scorer for this squad, leading the offense. That's an obvious one as well. And, you got to shout out Adams, who we talked about her as well. The way, the precision passing she has and on the draw control, got to be Hawkeye.
Emma Ward as Hulk as well. She uses her frame to get towards Cage. She moves around. She gets angry offensively, finds cutters towards Cage, and just passes it with will. Two times she's had 7 assists. That's a career high. She's really balling out for this SU offense.
Yeah, she's such a physical player. That's why I like the comparison there. Like you said, she uses her frame. She's got speed and size and strength. She's so good around the crease, whether it's moving defenders around her to find other people to get open, or just from outside. We know that shot is incredible.
It's got a lot of velocity.
Yeah, exactly.
And guys, why I love this comparison so much is when you think about the Avengers, you know, that scene in New York City, the only group that to stop a world invasion of aliens is every single one of the Avengers all together, band up together. And that's the same thing for this SU squad, right? They all have to work together. They all have to be those superheroes we've talked about to claim that national championship trophy.
You see this video behind us here. It's almost so intimidating, right? And that's what this Syracuse women's lacrosse team has been all season long. They've been an intimidating squad that just beats down on opponents left and right. 2 more games to go, the 2 toughest opponents it will have for the rest of the season. But Jack, the intimidating factor is why it makes this comparison just so great.
It really does. You know why I love how Syracuse women's lacrosse is the Avengers? It's because in these past few seasons, things haven't gone the way they wanted it to. You know, you lose in the championship a couple years back to Boston College. Last year, you got a banged up, injured squad. Well, let's avenge that. Let's put together a squad. Let's assemble a team to break through and win a national championship. That's what these Avengers are all about.
Run through a brick wall.
Let's do it.
I mean, look, Syracuse is like the Avengers. It has to play like the Avengers in these next 2 games. But before we go to predictions, before we preview Syracuse and North Carolina, finish that up, it's Leo Silverman's final show for CitrusTV in the sports department. He spent his entire collegiate career here with CitrusTV. We just want to say thank you for everything that you've done. You always have a smile on your face. You're one of the nicest guys.
Look
at the smile. I mean, it's just wonderful. You're one of the nicest guys I've ever met. You've welcomed everybody here at this station with open arms, and we just can't thank you enough for everything you did, or have done, rather, here at the station. And I'm so excited, I could speak for Jack as well, to see what you do going forward. So, shout out Leo Silverman.
I appreciate you guys. No clue they were going to do this. I appreciate you for the sentiment.
I can see you're a bit.
I'm a bit caught off guard.
You're
definitely
caught off guard. Hey, that's okay. But Jack, well, I'm going to Jack first. All due.
Makes sense. Give some time.
Let him regroup.
I'm going to.
Wasn't in the rundown. Let him regroup.
I'm going to Jack first here. Let's set the scene. #1 Syracuse women's lacrosse. #5 North Carolina. Chapel Hill, Dorrance Field, undefeated record at stake. Megan Tyrell can score more than 8 points. Does she? Does Syracuse win?
More than 8 points. Wow, that's a lot.
I gave you a lot of questions.
I'll start with this. Leo, thank you for your time here. I just have to say that first. And yes, Syracuse gets it done. They win this game. It's going to be a bloodbath in Syracuse all the way down to North Carolina. They're going to get it done 12-11 in overtime. I think they stick it out through the end.
And Jack, for the last time, my score prediction here. I'm giving SU the win. You knew I was going to do it. 11-9, a 2-goal win, because that's exactly what the Tar Heels gave them here in the 315. Mr. Storylines himself. There's just too much revenge for SU to drop this one. They're going to bring that win and move to 13-0.
You mean 15-0. 14-0.
They usually add when you win the game, they usually put 1 in the win category, not take 1 away.
Okay. Crazy concept.
I got Syracuse 17-13. I'm not like these guys. I don't think it's going to be a close game. I think it's going to be one of those contests where Syracuse gets off to a hot start. North Carolina plays catch up the whole way. Jack, you said overtime. interesting.
I think it's a tight one.
Nothing better than extra lacrosse. I don't think you see it in Dorrance Field. I think Syracuse wins this one. But from Leo Silverman, Jack Gordon, I'm Ben Spector, saying so long and enjoy the contest between SU and UNC.